Amma, you want to leave the meeting or do you want me to throw you out? You don't even give the teacher the time to at least stop the annotations. Come on, grow up. Are you there, Amma, or you've left? Yes, Yash, Yadav. Have you tried your hands on checking whether the scribbling is still on or not? Anybody else wants to see whether we can still scribble the screen? Can please go ahead. Anyone? Sure, because two students, yes. Chembur Omkar, are you done with your painting? You still have the guts to do it even after the teacher is telling you all this? Okay, I have one more student, very good. Vijay? See, you don't put your real name in the class. As I know, everybody is told to keep their center names, and few students just enter the class. Tanishka, I assume that you've done it by mistake. Chembur, Babu Bhai and all, everyone we have in the class. Very good. Full of Bollywood masala. No, that's not true, because it was just a single dot by her. So I said it's by mistake. I am not biased towards all that, Chennai. I hope you get my point now. As I think you all can see the names of the students who are scribbling the screen, right? I am not the only one who is able to see that. So how does it make that I do not take names of girls who have done it? I do take names of the girls who are doing it. But the girls don't do it. That is the main thing. Anyways, apart from all these things, apart from all discussing about our artists in the class, let us come back to our chemistry. And that is our important stuff which we were doing in the last class. That was IUPAC. I'm pretty sure abhi tak sabko IUPAC ka concept clear ho gaya. No more questions related to a nomenclature. Did you all practice the examples which are given in the textbook? Yes, you all practice. Very good. Numbering you will come to know when you do more examples. See, numbering shouldn't be an issue. You have to remember one thing: whenever you are doing IUPAC, you start numbering from both the sides. Left se right bhi number kar do, or right se left bhi number kar do. Uske baad, what are you going to check for? Dekho, examples mein carbon hydrogen to mandatory hone hi wala hai. So what are the different things that might be present in an example? That can be either the functional group of aldehyde, alcohol, ketone, carboxylic acid or amines. Or there might be an exception of halogens, or there might be an exception of double bond or triple bond. So when these things are present apart from the carbon and hydrogens, you're going to give numbering to them. And that numbering should be in the minimal possible way. So left se right or right se left mein jo bhi minimum number of carbon hoga, usko hum select karenge. Okay. So after that, we also started with the chemical properties of carbon compound, where we've already covered one reaction, one property, that is combustion. And what is the meaning of combustion? What is the meaning of combustion? Burning in the presence of oxygen. Very nice. We have learned that when saturated hydrocarbons, they burn with blue flame, unsaturated with, they give a black smoke. And then we did examples of alkanes and alcohols. Alkanes, when they are burned in the presence of oxygen, or alcohol, when they are burned in the presence of oxygen, they give us carbon dioxide, water and heat and light. These are the common product: carbon dioxide, water and heat and light. And then I had given you homework for propane. Thank you, Shivani, but I feel balancing is somewhere gone wrong. In place of oxygen, the oxygen, just check. I think that is wrong. Yes, homework was given by me. No, I had told you to do propane ka combustion, that is present as one of the component in our LPG. How many of you have done that? Shivani, oxygen should be 5O2 because product mein oxygen is 10 only. In product, I have only 10 oxygen. Okay, you've done very good. In the product, for those, Shivani, for balancing, in the product you have, for carbon dioxide, it becomes 3 multiplied by 2, that is 6. And for water, there is 4 in front of water. So it is 4. So 6 plus 4 gives me 10. So it should be 5O2 in the reactant. So the answer would be C3H8 plus 5O2 giving me 3CO2 plus 4H2O. All right, this was the only homework which I had given, which, like always, the few students who are always available on the chat box give to me, and they've told me they've done. So now moving ahead, let us move to the next type of reaction, that is called as oxidation. We've already studied about oxidation reaction, isn't it? We'll come to that, Devansh. That is not a lot of examples given to you, so I have not given you the namings for that. Oxidation we have done, right? Oxidation reactions, the reactions in which reactants gain oxygen and lose hydrogen is called as oxidation reaction. Carbon compounds are completely oxidized during combustion. Chemical compounds can also be used as a source of oxygen. Substances that can give oxygen to other substances are called as oxidants, or they will be called as oxidizing agents. This is the recap of what we have done in the second chapter. And do you remember the names of the oxidizing agents? Two I have already shown you on the screen. That is potassium permanganate and potassium dichromate. Apart from that, we've also discussed about two oxidizing agents. Ozone, very good, Vedant. Apart from ozone, which was one more oxidizing agent which we had discussed? Potassium permanganate tha, potassium dichromate tha, ozone tha. And very nice, Vedant. H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide. Samarth, very good. Very nice. You all remember, no? Ki textbook mein peeche dekh ke bola. If you remember, very good. Textbook mein peeche dekha, toh bhi I don't mind. Why? Because at least you took efforts to see the answer. So potassium permanganate and potassium dichromate are the commonly used oxidizing agents. An oxidizing agent will affect only the certain functional group present in the carbon compound. So they are going to affect the functional group which is present in the carbon compound. Let us see how they are going to do that. So in oxidation reaction, I'm going to carry out oxidation of ethanol. What is the name of this compound? 2-carbon. Everybody, am I audible to everyone? Am I audible? Okay, so Sneha, please check on your side. There might be some internet issue because I think I'm clear. My voice is clear, right? So my dear students, now tell me, what is the name of this compound? CH3CH2OH. Ethanol or ethanol. So I'm going to carry out oxidation of ethanol. When I say oxidation, that means I'm going to add an oxidizing agent. And that oxidizing agent is, which I'm going to use in this reaction, is acidified potassium permanganate. When I say acidified potassium permanganate, see here now the problem is, students. Here it is alkaline. I'm sorry, not acidified. In the textbook, they have given you acidic, but we are using alkaline potassium permanganate. And I have written nascent oxygen above the arrow of potassium permanganate, which means that it is going to give us the nascent oxygen. Can you think what might be the expected product here? If I want to add oxygen in the reactant of ethanol, what might be the expected product? If you are seeing the textbook, I'm pretty sure everybody has got the answer as ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. But ethanoic acid bana kaise? Now let me tell you one thing, students. Oxygen ka valency kitna hai? What's the valency of oxygen? 2, right? The valency of oxygen is 2. That means oxygen will require 2 bonds. Oxygen requires 2 bonds, isn't it? ऑक्सीजन को दो बॉन्ड की जरूरत है और कार्बन के पास इफ यू सी हियर हियर दिस कार्बन इज अटैच्ड टू टू हाइड्रोजन एटम्स हियर कैन यू सी टू हाइड्रोजन नाउ इफ आई वांट टू प्लेस दिस ऑक्सीजन हियर आई विल हैव टू रिमूव टू हाइड्रोजन डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द रीजन बिकॉज ऑक्सीजन का वैलेंसी टू है और हाइड्रोजन का वैलेंसी वन ही है सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू अटैच वन ऑक्सीजन आई विल हैव टू रिमूव टू हाइड्रोजन्स सो दैट इज वाई दीज टू हाइड्रोजन्स गो अवे and carbon gets attached to oxygen by having a double bond and we get the product as CH3COOH which is our carboxylic acid now is it clear everyone did you understand how did I get this carboxylic acid in the product now in this reaction hydrogen gas is also gone out hydrogen gas is gone out But that is not given in the textbook, so I have not mentioned here. But definitely, hydrogen will come out as the product, isn't it? I'll explain once again. So, your students, we are carrying out oxidation of ethanol. By using potassium permanganate, which is giving away the oxygen, which is giving the oxygen for oxidation. Now, if this oxygen has to come and attach, to the carbon, I will have to remove two hydrogens. The reason for removing two hydrogen is because oxygen ka valency is two and hydrogen ka valency is one. So when this oxygen is coming and trying to break the bond between carbon and hydrogen. The two hydrogens will go away, and if one oxygen is coming and attaching to the carbon, it is giving rise to a double bond. And related to this alkaline potassium permanganate, let me tell you one thing. In the current year textbook, they mentioned it as alkaline, but in the previous year textbook, it was acidic. In the previous year textbook, it was acidic, whereas in the current year, they are using alkaline. So I would suggest we all go with acidic potassium permanganate. Reason because when we have studied in the previous chapter, potassium permanganate, which you studied in the previous chapter also, there also they do it with the help of sulfuric acid, if you remember. Oxidation was done with the help of sulfuric acid. So instead of writing alkaline, please write acidic potassium permanganate. Are you all listening to me? Instead of writing alkaline, write acidic potassium permanganate. And then we get the product as carboxylic acid, which is CH3COOH. Did you all understand this now? Please write the equation under oxidation. And you know how this reaction is done? Have you seen the color change of phenolphthalein when added to a base? Did you ever get a chance to see this experiment in the laboratory? When phenolphthalein is added to a base, you see the pink color. You've never got the opportunity. Okay, few students have got, few have not got. For them, let me tell you. Do you remember when we used to check for acids and bases? So we used to add a few drops of phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein in acid is remaining colorless, whereas in base it turns pink. But when I add the phenolphthalein to the base, as soon as I add a drop, at the surface only I see a pink dot. But when I stir it, it disappears. Similarly, if I add one more drop, sometimes the color retains and sometimes it disappears. So this is the technique to check for oxidation as well. What do we do is, the pink colored solution of potassium permanganate. I'm pretty sure everybody sees potassium permanganate in the laboratory. It's a nice purplish pink colored solution. Now, as soon as I add this to the ethanol, initially, the color disappears, but when the color retains at a certain point of addition, when the complete oxidation has happened, on further addition, the color still becomes darker. When the color doesn't disappear, we come to know that the reaction is complete and the oxidation has got complete. I'm feeling bad for the students who are not able to see this reaction, but next year, if you continue to take science in future, definitely you will be doing a lot of these reactions where you see the color change happening very nicely. So did you all write about oxidation here? I was telling how the reaction is happening. The normal formula of ethanoic acid is still the same. This is the structural formula. If I will write the linear formula, it will simply be CH3COOH, which is my ethanoic acid. CH3COOH. It's the same. If you remember the functional group table, if you're having your textbook in hand, you can see the table where they have given the condensed formula and the structural formula. There you can see both the structures. C double bond OOH is also carboxylic acid. COOH is a carboxylic acid. Yes, it is the acetic acid, which is vinegar. Yeah, in the tent, if you see, I've shown you here, Shubham. कार्बन के नीचे ऑक्सीजन डाला है दैट डजंट कार्बन के ऊपर डबल बॉन्ड डाल के ओ डालो या नीचे डाल के डालो डजंट मैटर व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट कि यू आर पुटिंग इट ऑन द राइट कार्बन ऑन दैट इज व्हाट मैटर्स हियर सो लेट्स मूव अहेड नाउ वी हैव डन विद ऑक्सीडेशन दिस इज द थर्ड टाइप ओके इट हैज कम टू दिस इज द थर्ड टाइप The third type of reaction, which is addition reaction. As the name says, addition. We are simply going to add. Let us see how simply we can add in chemistry now. So now tell me, what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? C2H4, to iska formula hai. Iska naam kya hai? Very good. It is ethene. Very nice. Everybody was able to tell me the name. Come on, everyone. Kitne bachche baithe hain abhi class mein? 398 mein se, are you all listening students? We have got the formula of ethene. Now I am going to add something to this ethene. I am going to carry out hydrogenation reaction. Ethene, common name is also ethylene. Do not get confused. Pay attention. Ethene mein I am going to add hydrogen. Hydrogen is nothing but H2, right? Instead of writing H2, I have written H bond H. Instead of writing H2, I have written H bond H, just to make the reaction simpler. Is the reactant part clear to everyone? Haan, mujhe pata hai H2 zyada easy lag raha hoga, but maine purposely isko aise drop kiya. Let's understand why the teacher has done this. Think, मैं आंसर नहीं भी दूंगा तो भी तुमको आंसर आना चाहिए. Do you remember we studied alkanes, alkenes and alkynes? Alkane, alkene, alkynes याद है तुमको? जब alkane से alkenes बनता है तो दो हाइड्रोजन निकालते हैं ना हम जब alkane से alkene बनाते हैं तो we remove two hydrogen, right? तो अब मैं alkene में अगर हाइड्रोजन डालूंगी तो क्या बन जाएगा फिर से alkane. Is it simpler? Yes, it will become an ethane. No, very good. It will become an ethane. So what do I do? Jab main ek bond hata dungi, if you're removing the double bond from these two carbons, what will happen? Ye jo do hydrogen ka electrons hai, they will start come and attach here. See, hydrogen ke paas jo dot represent karke electron bata hai, wo yahan pe aake attach ho jayega. So because of which two new bonds are created, and from the double bond structure, I get a single bond. So unsaturated hydrocarbon has got converted into a saturated hydrocarbon. So this is our addition reaction. Usually addition reactions are always carried out which are hydrogenation. They are carried out in the presence of a catalyst, and the catalyst is either platinum or nickel. Platinum or nickel catalyst is used. These reactions are called as hydrogenation reaction. So here we are studying addition reaction, where an unsaturated hydrocarbon gets converted into a saturated hydrocarbon by using the reaction of hydrogenation. Aur kahan pe kiya hai humne hydrogenation? Kaun bata sakta hai mujhe? Let me see who is so smart. Where I have taught you hydrogenation reaction, where we use nickel catalyst, we've done. Should I give you a hint so that you can search the textbook? Okay, I've got an answer. Sorry, Manasvi, very nice. Shubham, lot of students are answering. That means everybody is knowing vegetable oil and vanaspati ghee. Very good, very good. Nice. I thought you would not know. Vegetable oil on undergoing hydrogenation at 60 degrees Celsius in the presence of nickel catalyst gets converted to vanaspati ghee. Isn't it? and then we get, so that means vegetable oil is a structure which is having a double bond. Vanaspati ghee is a structure having a single bond. Means vegetable oil is a vegetable oil is an unsaturated hydrocarbon and vanaspati ghee is a saturated hydrocarbon. Now this is simple to see in the reaction, but how do I get to know about these? How do I get to know about this? We do a small reaction here, small experiment, where we take 4 ml of oil in a test tube and I'm going to add 4 drops of tincture iodine. Have you heard about tincture iodine? Have you heard about tincture iodine? Anybody knows what's tincture iodine? It's simply a combination of iodine and alcohol, especially ethanol. Jab iodine aur ethanol ko mix karte hai, to usko hum bolte hai tincture iodine. Yes, it's usually found in first aid boxes. So I'm going to take oil in a test tube, add 4 drops of tincture iodine. Iodine is brownish in color. Shake the test tube. Find out whether the original color of the bromine or iodine disappears or not. This is the experiment which you were supposed to do it in the lab. Repeat the same procedure with the oil or with the vanaspati ghee. Let's see what's going to happen. In the above activity, what do I see is the observation of the disappearing or diminishing means the color of bromine or iodine indicates whether the bromine or iodine has been used up. This means that bromine has undergone a reaction with the concerned substance. That is called as an addition reaction. So what is addition? When a carbon compound combines with another carbon compound to form a product that contains all the atoms in both the reactants, it will be called as addition. Addition usko hi bolenge jab sab kuch add ho jayega. Reactant mein jitna bhi present hai, jaise hamara combination. Jaise reactant mein jo bhi present hai, wo sab mix karke ek product banega, to usko hum bolenge addition reaction. Unsaturated compounds contain multiple bonds. As we have discussed, vegetable oil contains multiple bond. They undergo addition reaction to form a saturated compound, that is my product. And the addition reaction of unsaturated compound with iodine or bromine takes place instantaneously at room temperature. So from the above activity, can we conclude that the color of iodine disappears in the reaction between oil and iodine? Because you are not able to see, I'm giving you the inference also. Color of iodine or bromine disappears in the reaction between oil and iodine. There is no color change happens in vanaspati ghee. So this change of color helps us understand, or the iodine test tells me that there is multiple bonds present in oil, whereas in vanaspati ghee it is only single bond, that is it is saturated. So molecules of vegetable oil contains long and unsaturated carbon chains, and hydrogenation transforms them into saturated chains, and thereby vanaspati ghee is formed, which is again a recap of the previous reaction, that is vegetable oil plus hydrogen in the presence of nickel catalyst. This is what it is shown to us in the textbook. So the unsaturated, they can also ask you in the exam that students how to convert unsaturated compound into saturated one. They might directly not ask you. So when they ask you in the textbook, they have given us only this much, but I have already explained to you the reaction, where a carbon to carbon double bond undergoes hydrogenation in the presence of platinum or nickel as the catalyst, it gets converted into single bond. So everyone please write this reaction. This is the same reaction which we have written previously. जो इसके पहले मैंने तुमको reaction बताया था ना, ethene getting converted to ethane. Here they have not put more carbon bonds is because this is not restricted to only 2 carbons. This can move ahead with lot of carbons. Yes, it's okay. You concentrate there, no? This is it's a general chemical equation where carbon atoms can be added more. Did you understand why I did not write H? PT means platinum. PT means platinum, Ni means nickel. Few students, your video are on. Please switch it off because other friends of yours are more concerned in why the video is on. there is no edge one because it can be continued further. What am I trying to say is hum log usko straight chain branch chain aisa structure ko elaborate kar sakte hain. Have you all written this? So let's move on to the next type of reaction now. Yes, Shritij will talk about it. The third, fourth type is substitution reaction. We have done oxidation. I'm sorry, we have done combustion, oxidation, addition, and the fourth type is substitution. So substitution means ek ki jagah pe dusre ko add karna hai. Let's see how we are going to do that. As the single bonds in carbon and hydrogen and carbon-carbon bonds are very strong. Saturated hydrocarbons are usually not reactive and therefore they remain inert in most of the reagents. But saturated hydrocarbons in the presence of sunlight reacts rapidly with chlorine. In the presence of sunlight means in the presence of ultraviolet rays, they react rapidly with chlorine. In this reaction, chlorine atoms replace one by one all the hydrogen atoms in the saturated hydrocarbon. So the reaction in which the place of one type of atom or group of reactant is taken by another atom or group of atoms will be called as substitution reaction. So here we are replacing the things with the help of one type of atom or another or a group of atoms. And the reaction which we are going to study now is called chlorination of methane. It is called as chlorination of methane. Let's try to understand the chlorination of methane now. Everybody please concentrate on the screen because the four step reaction, I am teaching you only one step, rest three steps you are going to do. It's a four step reaction. One step I will teach you. Chlorination means jab hum chlorine add karne wale. Reactions in which chlorine is added. So everyone concentrate on the screen. Please don't see whose videos are on or off. So one I will teach you, rest three you will do. They are very simple. So I said chlorination of methane. Ye statement se humko kya samajh mein aata hai? My reactant is going to be methane. That is my CH4. Instead of writing CH4, I have written C and 4H with the bond. I am going to add chlorine. What will be the formula of chlorine? What will be the formula of chlorine? Cl2. Very good. Cl2. Chlorine is a gas. Cl2. So instead of writing Cl2, again I am writing Cl bond Cl. Correct? And on the arrow, I am going to write sunlight because I said ultraviolet rays are required. Now here, one H from methane and one Cl from chlorine, they both combine with each other and will form what? HCl. So one of my product which I get is HCl. Abhi jab H chala gaya hai, और यहाँ पे भी एक Cl अकेला है, so this Cl is going to take the place of H. Do you agree? जो H को हमने निकाला, उसका place vacant है, and here one Cl is also vacant, so this Cl will go and attach to the methane. So methane now becomes methyl chloride. Methane is now becoming methyl chloride, which is a common name, और इसका IUPAC name हो जाएगा chloromethane. IUPAC name ho jayega chloromethane. Very good, Shrey. You very nicely or always quick with the answers of IUPAC. Got it, everyone? Now, this substitution reaction, this is the first step. Ye first step hai, jisme maine chlorination kiya. Same way, in the second step, jo mera product hai, the product which I have here, which is CH3Cl, that will become my reactant. CH3Cl will become my reactant. I will add more chlorine. So what is going to happen then? Mere product mein agar main aur chlorine dalu to kya hoga abhi? Come on, think what is going to happen? Dichloro, very good. It will become 2 chlorine. Do 3H mein se fir se H nikal denge hum log. Isn't it? It will release one more HCl and instead of CH3Cl, it will become CH2Cl2. Very good. It will become CH2Cl2. Similarly, again the next step, third step. Abhi third step likho. Third step mein, hum log fir se chlorine add karte hain. CH2Cl2 mein. Now what is going to happen? One more H is going to remove and it is going to replace the Cl. So it will become CHCl3. Very nice. So what will be the fourth step? Obviously, fourth step kya hoga? What is the fourth step? Yes, CCl4, that is carbon tetrachloride. Finally, all the 4H of methane gets replaced by Cl in four different steps and I get the final product as carbon tetrachloride. Did you get it, everyone? Did you understand? So now you were answering to me on the chat box. Please, everybody, write this in your notebook. Substitution reaction. So this is called as chlorination of methane, where on methane gas, I am adding chlorine and making it get converted into chloride compounds. So that is why it is called as chlorination of methane. You don't have to write the reaction in this format. You can simply write these four steps this way also. You will get marks in the exam. Those reactions I gave to make you understand how Cl is attaching in place of H. So quickly write this, please. Yes, it can be done by all the alkanes. Methane is just an example. It can be done by any alkane. So substitution reactions are what? These are the reactions in the place of one atom or group of atoms is taken by another atom or group of atoms. Replacement. Jahan hum log replace kar rahe hain ek ko dusre ke saath, it becomes substitution. In addition, we were adding, in substitution, replacing. Substitution and displacement are two different things. In displacement, what is happening? You can say it's a type of displacement only, substitution. Jaise combination or addition same ho jata hai, waisa hi substitution or displacement bhi same ho sakta hai. Done, everyone. Finished writing substitution. So we have completed under chemical properties ka topic mein four types of reaction. And I'm pretty sure all four were simple. They were not difficult at all. See, that is the bond which you are seeing here. What I said, bond is not mandatory. So if you represent it with bond and if you do not represent it with bond, it's still the same. No, the reactant, Mridini, the reactant has to be the fourth reactant you are telling, no, fourth step. Mein. That is the product of the third step, no. It's a product of the third step. No, we'll write carbon first. How can it? No, no, Devansh, that's not correct way to write. No problem, your doubt is solved, that is important. वैभव अभी एडिशन याद आया. एडिशन रिएक्शन में क्या होता है, हम लोग अनसैचुरेटेड से सैचुरेटेड में कन्वर्ट करते हैं बाय एडिंग हाइड्रोजन. अनसैचुरेटेड मींस वंस व्हिच आर हैविंग डबल बॉन्ड और सैचुरेटेड मींस वंस व्हिच आर हैविंग सिंगल बॉन्ड. और हाइड्रोजन ऐड करने का इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ निकल और प्लैटिनम कैटलिस्ट, दैट इज एडिशन रिएक्शन. एंड सब्स्टिट्यूशन इज द वन व्हिच वी आर डूइंग नाउ. ओके, so now in this later part of the chapter we have to study about commercially important carbon compounds. Commercially important carbon compounds are two compounds we are going to study. One is ethanol and one is ethanoic acid. First I will start with ethanol. I'm sure everybody has heard about ethanol, right? Ethanol and ethanoic acid both are commercially important carbon compounds. The formula of ethanol becomes C2H5OH. Linear formula can be also represented as CH3CH2OH. Isme beech mein bond dalega to bhi same hi answer hota hai. CH3 bond CH2 bond OH. And structural formula is this. This is just a basics quick recap we are doing. ethanol. Let's see what are the properties of ethanol now. At room temperature, colorless ethanol is a liquid and at boiling point is 78 degrees Celsius. Generally, ethanol is also called as alcohol or spirit because that's a commonly used one. Ethanol is soluble in water in all the proportions. When aqueous solution of ethanol is tested with litmus paper, it is found to be neutral. Consumption of, this is very important now. Consumption of small quantity of dilute ethanol shows its effect. Even though it is condemned, still it has remained socially widespread practice. I hope you all understand this. Consumption of alcohol, it really is harmful to our health in number of ways. Let me tell you what happens when I consume alcohol. It adversely affects the psychological processes and the central nervous system. And consumption of even a small quantity of pure ethanol, I'm telling you, that is absolute alcohol, can be lethal. Ethanol is a very good solvent. Let me tell you the other part of it. Ethanol is a very good solvent. It is used in medicines such as tincture, iodine, which we have discussed earlier, cough mixtures, and in many tonics. Lethal means harmful, which is dangerous for your health. And one more important thing. This is about ethanol, which has been a widespread practice to be used. But methanol, which is the lower version of ethanol, is poisonous. And intake of small quantity of it can also affect the vision. And it can be really lethal. Lethal means dangerous, harmful. So that is why in the laboratory, you know, when we need methanol, it is always mixed with a small quantity of ethanol. Because few intelligent students might feel that alcohol jab laboratory mein available hai, to kyun na use kare. And usually methanol mein blue dye is also added to understand the differentiation. So this was about the properties. Few questions can be asked related to the properties. Let's come to the chemical properties of ethanol, which is very important for you to understand. The first type which you are going to learn is reaction with sodium metal. So at least I think my students should be able to write the reactant now. I am going to do the reaction of ethanol with sodium metal. Chalo, reactant to likh ke batao. What are going to be the reactants here? Okay, very good, very good. So let's see, as you've given me the reactant, Shivani, ethanol ke saath karna hai, tumne methane ke saath kiya. Don't jump to the product. I don't want the products. I only want you to understand the reactant first. So my reactant is ethanol. So when sodium comes in contact with ethyl alcohol, that is ethanol, it releases hydrogen. Abhi to maine ethanol ka formula bataya tha sabko. C2H5OH, which can also be written as CH3 bond, CH2 bond. इसलिए इसके पहले मैंने तीनों अलग टाइप के एग्जाम्पल्स बता दिए तुमको. In what ways we can write the formula of ethanol? C2H5OH plus Na, that is sodium. Now what does sodium do? You know, sodium is a metal of high reactivity, right? Sodium is a metal of high reactivity. So sodium breaks the bond between O and H. Sodium breaks the bond between O and H. As you can see here, yahan pe bhi bond hota hai na ek. So sodium goes and breaks the bond between this O and H and it removes the hydrogen from here. Hydrogen ka valency kya hai? What's the valency of hydrogen? 1. Hydrogen ka valency 1 hai. Sodium ka valency kya hai? Sodium ka valency is also 1. So when I'm removing this hydrogen, sodium is easily going and taking the place adjacent to this O. H ka jagah kaun lega abhi? Sodium. So what will be the product now? What will be the product now? Because dono ka valency one hai na, they can replace each other. So my product becomes C2H5ONA. Very nice, Risha. C2H5ONA. And this is one of the product. And humne nikala kya tha usme se? Hydrogen. But we all know single hydrogen does not exist. So I get the product as hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas gets liberated and the product which I get is called as sodium ethoxide. देखो C2H5 मतलब सोडियम हुआ, सॉरी C2H5 मतलब इथ, O मतलब ऑक्सीजन और Na का मतलब सोडियम. सो द नेम बिकम्स सोडियम इथ ऑक्साइड. सोडियम इथ ऑक्साइड प्लस हाइड्रोजन गैस गेटिंग लिबरेटेड. एंड यू माइट बी थिंकिंग कि मैम इसको NaO क्यों नहीं लिख सकते, क्योंकि हम तो केमिस्ट्री पढ़ रहे थे तब से हमने सोडियम ऑक्साइड पढ़ा है. स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज नॉट आयोनिक बॉन्ड, दिस इज कोवैलेंट बॉन्ड. हियर दे आर शेयरिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, दे आर नॉट गिविंग एंड टेकिंग. NaO विल बी फॉर्मड व्हेन देयर इज गिव एंड टेक ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. रादर NaO तो बनेगा ही नहीं, Na2O बनता है, बट स्टिल दैट इज फॉर्म बाई गिव एंड टेक ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. बट हियर इट इज शेयरिंग, हाइड्रोजन वॉज शेयरिंग द बॉन्ड विद ऑक्सीजन. तो सोडियम ने क्या किया, हाइड्रोजन का जगह लिया. तो सोडियम हमको सिर्फ एच को निकाल के एनए डालना है, दैट्स द ओनली थिंग व्हाट वी आर डूइंग हियर. गॉट माय पॉइंट? यस. अगर के की जगह पे पोटेशियम लिया तो पोटेशियम इथॉक्साइड बन जाएगा. डिड यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड रिएक्शन विद सोडियम मेटल? सी फर्स्ट टाइम कोई भी चीज समझना मुश्किल है, या rather इतना मुश्किल नहीं है, but still if you're finding it difficult, you should not panic के ये topic ही समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. Give it time, you will understand. Now please write, and I want you all to practice the balancing. I will show you the balancing, but I want all of you to try the balancing. First try what answer you are getting, then I will give you the answer. बैलेंसिंग में क्या हिंट होता है, लेफ्ट राइट देखो और बैलेंस करो. आई एम आस्किंग यू टू बैलेंस द इक्वेशन. नो, इट इज नॉट टू बी स्टडीड इन द लेबोरेटरी, दे आर सपोज टू बी प्रैक्टिकली अंडरस्टूड इन द लेबोरेटरी. थियोरेटिकली तो हमको पढ़ना ही पड़ेगा. फर्स्ट स्लाइड ऑफ इथेनॉल अमोंग आई विल शो यू. देवांश आर यू श्योर एवरीवेयर? Because some of you want to see the different forms of ethanol, or what, that wala slide you want. Srishti, it is needed, dear. Check left, right, check karo. Dekho, basic cheez to yehi hai ki hydrogen left mein one tha, jo OH ka H hai na, wo right mein jaake H2 ho gaya. Pirzan, first question you asked me throughout the lecture is the lecture over? I am talking and how can you ask me ki is the lecture over? Wo bhi koi doubts to poocha hi nahi hai, direct a question. Yes, Devansh, now you're correct. Yes, Simone, very good. Yes, Calista, you're also correct. Okay, Ganesh has no doubt. Yes, Shivani. Vile parle amay surve. If he is so correct, why don't you leave the meeting and go? Why don't you all take the authority of leaving the class right away? I will not ask anyone why have you left the meeting. You are very well allowed to leave the meeting if you feel you are burdened with the class. I don't expect you to sit. Yes, it will be the same, Viraj. Yes, I'm sorry I missed your answer in the chat box because some very important questions were going on. Good, they left. Sorry, Shivani, I didn't see the answer. I'll give you the answer. Please check whether you all have got this answer or not. Sodium ethoxide because Na ke wajah se sodium aur C2H5 C2 hota hai to it aata hai aur isme beech mein oxygen hai isliye sodium ethoxide. This is the balancing what everybody's got. Very good. No, Calista, but we do arrange in January a laboratory for you all to see the experiments. Okay, let's do only one more reaction for today. I will not teach anything further. So after chemical properties of ethanol, we have to do one more reaction, that is dehydration reaction. As the name says, dehydration means what? D Dehydration means what? We'll discuss about that. Removing water. Removing water. Loss of water is called as dehydration reaction. So we are going to do dehydration of ethanol. So first I'm going to write ethanol, which is heated at 170 degrees Celsius with excess amount of sulfuric acid. Remember, dehydration reaction is carried out at 170 degrees Celsius with excess amount of concentrated sulfuric acid, and one molecule of water is removed. Let's see how. Now this is the reactant. Because we are studying chemical properties of ethanol, so it's definitely I'm going to take ethanol, that is C2H5OH or CH3CH2OH, which is at 170 degrees Celsius in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Come on, try to make the product. Please don't see the textbook. देखो तुम try करो तुमको आएगा. Water remove करना है बराबर. तो क्या निकलेगा इसमें से? 2H और 1O, right? This is how water will be removed. So what are we left with? What are we left with? CH3CH. But CH3CH बन सकता है क्या? CH3CH exist करेगा क्या? बताओ मुझे. Is it right type of bonding to write CH3CH? No, क्योंकि ये तो complete ही नहीं हुआ ना, stable ही नहीं होएगा structure. So हम लोग क्या करेंगे? CH3CH के जगह पे can I write CH2CH2 and put a double bond in between? Right? Can I do that? So when I adjust the hydrogen, I get a perfect product, which is my ethene. So ethanol on undergoing dehydration at 170 degrees Celsius in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid gets converted into ethene plus water is lost as it's a dehydration reaction. Got it, everyone? So please write this. Your concentrated sulfuric acid is acting as a dehydrating agent. अरे dehydration है ना, मतलब loss करना है water का. किसी भी चीज का loss कैसे लिखेंगे हम लोग? Product में दिखाएंगे तो loss हुआ ना, reactant में होगा तो gain होता है. How did the double bond came? I'll explain. अभी यहाँ पे जब हमने H2O निकाल दिया था, देखो इस H2 और इस O को निकाल दिया. Rather it can be any H and any O. It can be any H and any O. समझो मैंने ये H2O निकाल दिया. So we are left with CH3CH. Basically I have 2C and I have 4H, right? 2C and 4H. How will I arrange 2C and 4H? I'll have to give 2H to each carbon. In this way I'll give 2H to both of them. So एक कार्बन ने approximately 2 बॉन्ड बनाया, तो और कितना बॉन्ड बनाना बाकी है उसको? डबल बॉन्ड, राइट? सो दैट इज व्हाई आई गेट CH2, डबल बॉन्ड CH2. यस, यू कैन आल्सो राइट इट एज C2H4. इट इज अंडरस्टूड कि वो इथीन ही है. नो, डिहाइड्रेटिंग एजेंट इज नॉट सेम एज द कैटलिस्ट. हियर है ना, एक्सेस अमाउंट डालते हैं बट इथीन का कन्वर्जन हो जाता है ना. We don't get H2SO4 in the same form. So ethanol, when concentrated sulfuric acid at 170 degrees Celsius, the water gets lost and we are left with 2C and 2H. The 2C and 2H bond with each other, making a double bond, and I get the product as ethene. No, no, it is there in the reaction only. Chapter khatam ho gaya, mera bahut time hai abhi to. अभी तक तो हमको इथेनॉल करना है. इथेनॉल वी आर डन. सो वी हैव टू डू ओनली वन इथेनोइक एसिड एंड द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर, दैट इज आवर पॉलीमर्स. बस नहीं बाकी फिर हो गया. सो वी आर डन विद द क्लास टुडे. दोज हु हैव अंडरस्टूड और दोज हु आर रियली नॉट कीन कैन लीव द मीटिंग एंड दोज हु हैव डाउट्स कैन स्टे बैक.